Greetings. In this video, I would like to explain how to recover data from failed Dell Equallogic storages using our software UFS Explorer in case of hardware failure. So, consider the Dell Equallogic PS6210 model with small form factor drives. This is one of newest models with control module 15. There is no way to connect directly to the disk, so they must be removed and connected to a computer server for data recovery. For this, we can use any compatible SAS HBA board and disk shelf of a large or small form factor. We have to remove disks from standard Dell Equallogic enclosures and move them to compatible with our disk shelves. The same applies to Equallogic servers with larger factor drives, such as the PS6100 model. Now let's put these disks to disk shelves and make sure they are recognized properly. Now we have to make disk images. Especially if server failure was caused by disk failure. We can use any edition of UFS Explorer for this, but for convenience we will use UFS Explorer Technician or UFS Explorer Professional. Obviously, you can use any other compatible combination of software and hardware. We start imaging with default parameters and just wait. After successfully creating all or almost all disk images, it's time to move to logical data recovery. On all disks except the spare, the Equallogic server creates a pair of partitions with the same RAID configuration. The larger one is used for the data pool. In our case, the UFS Explorer Technician automatically recognized RAID 6. The parameters of this RAID are fixed, except the number of disks, and they can be reproduced in UFS Explorer Professional Recovery. If the storage policy was configured as RAID 50, the server creates a level 50 array, also with fixed parameters. If there are not enough drives for RAID 50, RAID 5 is created. Also, the storage policy can be set to RAID 10. The program recognizes such RAID as RAID 1E near with the same fixed stripe size of 64 kilobytes. In Equallogic servers, RAID 6 cannot include more than 16 drives, so quite often a couple of RAIDs is created. Also, additional arrays are created when expanding the data pool. Equallogic combines such arrays into span. When using UFS Explorer Technician and our plugin for Dell Equallogic, accessing the volumes is quite simple. The plugin should automatically recognize the super block and with it the data pool configuration. It also has a reference to some metadata. Metadata is required to load the list of volumes and their configuration. If successful, the plugin displays a list of volumes and their snapshots, without names. It also allows you to use the volume's main file system. If the plugin's license is active, it can add selected volumes to UFS Explorer. Obviously, the plugin only works with UFS Explorer Technician. If for some reason the superblock was lost, you can try to find it. And provide it to the plugin manually. The program will import the storage pool configuration and continue the process. In case of volume damage, it may happen that volume metadata will also be damaged. To solve this problem, you need to manually find the metadata block and provide it to the program. It can be found by specific keywords. Each metadata sector starts with 9 bytes of version number and sequence number of this metadata sector. The program needs to be provided with all the metadata sectors, but without any extra data at the end. This method can also be used to load other versions of metadata, for example, to try to restore deleted volumes. After successfully importing the metadata, the process will be the same. It's worth noting that only the metadata is mandatory, but not the superblock. If the RAID data pool is already assembled correctly, loading the superblock can be skipped. Please note that if there are several RAIDs in the configuration, the plugin will automatically build a span based on the data from the superblock. In any case, the output of plugin should be a volume added to UFS Explorer, which can be scanned if necessary and from which data can be copied. If you have your own Equallogic metadata converter, you don't need this plugin. Instead, you can use the mechanism of external data maps. They are compatible with both UFS Explorer Technician and Professional Recovery.